Now this budding also may be single budding, or multiple budding. Simple, single budding or multiple budding. Now we will start one by one. I will give one example of each, and you will be able to understand with that example. Remember, in case of amoeba or paramecium, they both divide by the process of binary fission. That means the body, if this is the body of amoeba, the body will divide into two separate daughter amoebae. Same in the case of amoeba. So this, since the body is divided into two individuals, two parts, it is called binary. Binary means two. Now multiple fission. In case of plasmodium, it is a protozoa. Of course, fission is there, but there are multiple fission in C. That means the individual breaks into several daughter cells, and at a time more than two organisms are formed. So since this division is in the form of multiple resultant, it is called multiple fission. Now let us come to budding. Now if you have seen Hydra, what happens at the time of reproduction? A bud grows out from the Hydra. Later, the bud attains a certain maturity. It develops tentacles, and now it is able to nourish it by its own. So it detaches itself from the main body and a separate new Hydra is formed. So since this was a single bud, this is called bud. This was a single bud. In case of Hydra, this is called single budding, and it is also a mode of reproduction. Unicellular or multicellular? Because it will create problem to you when I will, because this is not a unicellular. But it. Now multicellular, again multiple budding. In case of yeast, shall I erase this? I want to erase this so that I will get space. Okay, let me draw here. Yeast, it is a fungi. Unicellular. Now a bud grows from the main bud, and before it detaches, it buds very rapidly. Before the new bud detaches itself from the body, its own bud has grown at the same time, and the same bud can again have different buds over it. Before it detaches, many other buds can be grown. So suppose this is detaching from the main body, at the same time many other buds are also grown on this bud. So at that time, if we talk about the suppression of this, the first bud which grew from this one, at the same time many buds are there. So this type of budding is called multiple budding. Multiple budding, and in the case of yeast. Got it? So this was two type of division: fission, budding. Many more are there. According to your book, Conidia and zoospores are also given there. Now, in case of fungi, what happens when the fungi attains a certain maturity, a cyst is formed in which several spore-like structures are formed. These are called spores or zoospores, and this is called cyst. When these spores attain a certain maturity, the cyst burst out and the spores are released. When they get favorable condition, they grow into separate individuals. So this is called spore formation or zoo formation. And this is found in case of fungi. Same type of process is found in case of Penicillium, and it is called Conidia. The next is, according to your book, the next is Gemmule. It is found in the case of sponges. The process is almost same.